Hello, welcome to Sky Sweaty Record Review, episode 180. Oh my god, 181. I'm going to be reviewing blink 182, and I couldn't have waited one episode to make it funnier. You know what? It's funnier having it be blink 181. I mean, episode 181 about blink 182. Anyways, it's the first listen new music review show hosted by a French professor immediately after leaving the gym. And as I mentioned on the previous episode, which I released today, it's a two for Tuesday, meaning two episodes on one day with the same theme, pop punk music. I mentioned in the last video, which some of you may not have seen, I grew up in the 90s and I was huge into hardcore music, Slapshot, Sand Black Church, all that stuff, right? You probably never even heard of those bands. Why have you never heard of those bands? Because me, my culture lost. My angry culture with no melody lost. And instead it was replaced by bands like Green Day and Blink 182 that we're going to be reviewing today. The concept of pop punk. In my last video about She, Her, Hers, I talked about its utility. And I still believe it, that I was a complete idiot for dismissing all these bands. You know, they were expressing interesting emotional truths. They were using guitars. They were being actual bands, playing actual music as opposed to computers. For the most part, it was authentically expressed, and its main sin was that it was catchy. But I like catchy music. Catchy music is well written. Mozart is catchy. So, you know, this album by Blink 182 is called 9, but it might as well be called 1, because it's called 9 because it's their 9th album. But I've never listened to them, with one small exception. I'll tell you about that exception in a second. Now, when I tell you that I dismissed Blink 182, they were probably the most dismissed you could possibly be. Because there was this time in the late 90s, early 2000s, when I was in my mid-20s, which is exactly the worst time to be exposed to new music. there are all these bands that came out, and they all had numbers. And any band with a number at this point, I just mixed together. Three Doors Down was the same thing as Blink 182, was the same thing as Maroon 5, was the same thing as Third Eye Blind, was the same thing as 41, Sum 41. It all was the same to me. I was totally wrong. I was a complete idiot, but whatever. You know, when you're young and certain, you're the stupidest you'll ever be for two reasons, primarily the certainty. So here I am in my 40s, much like the band is, I assume, and I'm listening to them for the first time. And I've just gotten off this experience of listening to this wonderful Kill the Boy Band track by She, Her, Hers, and the whole genre of pop punk is opening up to me. And if you're like me, if you're some old dude who thinks that pop punk is just garbage, come into my world and explore with an open mind the concept that maybe pop punk isn't terrible. Now, these guys have been around forever. I mean, just forever. I mean, late 90s, that's a long time. And the only time I've ever listened to them on purpose was about a month ago. My daughter, who, as I've mentioned several times, is on sort of an emo kick. And so she's asking me about all these bands, and some of them I know about and some of them I don't. And she's like, what about Blink 182? I'm like, I don't know. And I immediately get out Tidal and I start playing Blink 182 just because I want to have an open mind and show her that, you know, what do I know? What do I know about Blink 182? And I played her all the hits. All the small things, nah, nah. And I'm like, okay. So I've never taken this song seriously, but it's a really good song. All the Small Things is a great track. And I don't know, whatever I was doing in the early 2000s that led me to completely abandon the chance of them being a good band, I was just not being very smart. So I was happy when they released a new album because there's a chance for me to take them very seriously. It's a pretty spotty record. Why don't I, because I like to be positive. Let me focus on the stuff that I really like. I think probably the stamp of the album is the track number 2, Happy Days. And this really showcases their ability of using great melody. They can write a really happy chorus. They can use dynamics really well, you know, kind of getting quiet, getting loud. The first track, which I didn't love, First Time, it actually has like basically a Smashing Pumpkins guitar line, which then drops out to some electronic stuff. They do a lot of great soft and loud things, always with these great soaring choruses that have some kind of hook to them. So I'll play you a little bit of Happy Days right now, so you get a sense of like what makes them engaging and good. Like, if you can listen to this and not just say, punk has to be angry and hard and jagged. If you can get over that concept, and frankly, Green Day should have done that. I can't wait for Green Day to release an album so I can take them seriously too. Just listen to it with an open ear for their talent with melody and song structure. Back up against the wall. Is it the life that you wanted? When you could never have it all. I wanna feel happy days, happy days, happy days, happy days. All through isolation inside of my brain. And I don't know if I made a change. Probably my favorite thing about this band is the thing that I liked about them the least, which is their drummer. So, you know, the drummer, Travis Barker, was kind of like a celebrity, and I don't know, he was in some kind of plane crash or something, and he was on a reality TV show, and he's sort of like everything that I associated with, like, stupid young people, you know? He's always walking around with his shirt off with all of his tattoos, you know, about being from California. I was just like, man, this guy's a buster. He's so lame. He is such a good drummer. Could someone tell me, is there any computer-assisted drumming? I mean, sometimes there's a drum machine instead of a drummer. But there are songs on here where he's, like, playing solos and he's playing fills. And they are so good that it's hard to actually believe that they're played by a human. In particular, there's these sort of, there's this one really good short song called Generational Divide, which is probably my favorite track on the album just because it's really short. And it's basically just a drum solo with some singing over it. In kind of a similar way, another one of my favorite tracks is one of the other very short tracks called Ransom. I actually almost skipped this track because the album's very long and my workout was only like half an hour. But I listened to it on the way back from the gym and it's great. It's like less than 2 minutes, I think. And it's just an interesting song about the way that, like, young love can feel hopeful, but then at the end, you can feel like you're being held ransom by somebody. And I don't know. I think that's an interesting theme to explore, the feeling of being in a ransom, a hostage situation when you are in a relationship. There's sort of a fun thing is, you know, if you watch my last video, which I'm going to learn how to do, I'm going to put a link up there. I hope that works. By She, Her, Hers, a lot of that is about destroying the sort of toxic masculinity of punk music. And there are a few tracks on here which are really kind of regressive in the way they perceive of romantic relationships. The track Dark Side is like all about this girl who's from another world and she's going to bring me to the dark side. It's like, no, dude, you're responsible for your own actions. If you do something stupid, it's not because a woman does something stupid and you want to be like her. I know that from experience. Another track, I Really Wish I Hated You, is sort of like kind of a stalkery track, you know, about being better when I'm broken. And in general, the take on love here is very immature. And I wonder, like, how much can you have a mature pop punk? Like, is immaturity a part of this genre? Do you have to have sort of a stupidity and innocence to sing something as silly as a song like I Really Wish I Hated You? I don't know. There is, I would say, the biggest downfall to this record is the fact that it's very clearly, there's a lot of interference. I think label interference. But like when you look at the written by, you know, it's a trio and it's a very well put together trio. They're all good at their instruments. The guy sings really well. But then like the songs are written by like 10 people. So like, And then you get to a track called Blame It On My Youth. And it's like, oh, guys, oh, you're just embarrassing yourselves. I mean, it's not a bad song, but it's like they're trying to be Imagine Dragons. And remember, I like Imagine Dragons, so I'm not saying Imagine Dragons is bad, but any band that's trying to sound like Imagine Dragons, you're really in a world of hurt. Just the way the chorus is written, it's kind of, the army of producers, and like the mixture of like electronic and acoustic instruments, it's pretty painful. It's very clear that, look, I don't know if this happened, but it's pretty evident to me that the studio, you know, some guy was like, I don't hear a single. Okay, we'll just make an Imagine Dragons song. One track, I think it's the only one that's just the three of them songwriting. It's a track called On Some Emo S-Word. And it's weird because it's like a satirical take on emo, but the lyrics are in earnest. I don't quite know. Another great drum song, and another, perhaps my favorite track on the album, this or Happy Days, a track called Pin the Grenade. And this is some of the best lyrics. I really like the concept of, if you don't love me, lie to my face. So somebody who wants to live in a bad situation. It seems like the singer in this album is not in a good place in his life, and he appears to be communicating that pretty clearly. Another great drum line that leads through. I'm going to say something a little bit heretical. Heretical. That's how you pronounce that word. Hérétique in French. But Travis Barker is kind of Keith Moon-ish. By that, I mean, like, he does a lot of fills, and at times, like, there's a lyricism to his fills that actually, like, serve, like, almost like a melody, or, you know, like, he doesn't just play drums. It's like he's playing a drum solo as drums. So he's not as good as Keith Moon, and I don't like him nearly as much. But still, there's something to that in the way that he plays, a kind of, like, awesome gonzo energy. So, there you go. There's my review of Blink 182. I don't know what I'm gonna put for my 3-word description of either of these albums. I'm happy that I did this. I'm happy that I took old pop punk seriously and new pop punk seriously. And I think just in the future, I'm just gonna have to accept that High School Sky was, as he often would be, quite wrong. Okay, until next time, where I will not be reviewing punk. Who knows what I'll be reviewing? There's the camera.